Passion is a powerful thing. Some people go through their whole life never knowing what their passion really is. For me, it's travel and fishing. I used to sit in my office and wonder what it would be like to take a whole year off and fish my way across America. Well, my dream finally came true. I did take a whole year off just to go fishing. I traveled the back roads in search of America's finest fly fishing destinations. The trip was so great that I took a second year off, and then a third. Yeah, passion is a powerful thing. This year, I started in Louisiana, where I grew up. Not much has changed since I left. The people are still friendly, and the fishing is still incredible. I made my way to Burris, just south of New Orleans, where I met up with Ryan Lambert, the redfish master.
Did you see that thing?
I think he come chasing right after it, right on top.
What do they think this fly is, that one I just put on? Crab?
Crab. They eat crabs constantly. And what they'll do, they'll take, a lot of times when they're eating a crab pattern, they'll take it in so deep because they have a crusher in the back of their throat.
Yeah.
And they'll get that crab back in and just crush it and hold it in that crusher. You ever get your finger in there, you'll know all about it.
There he is.
I'll show it to you when you get this fish in. I'll show you that crusher.
So I can get him on the reel here.
There you go. Now you got him.
Got him?
Yeah, got him. Pretty fish.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Pretty. He's got gold colors on him.
God, he ate it, man. They got a tough mouth.
They got a few little teeth in there, but not much. You see the crusher down there?
Yeah.
Did you actually see those spikes in there, huh?
Yeah, that's
how they... Go ahead, stick your finger in there. I'll show you how he does it.
No, thank you.
Come on. it don't bleed anything. It just hurts real bad.
I'm going to take your word on this.
Let's let that pretty baby go.
Pull that in there. I got it.
He said, never had a Cajun turn away a redfish until now.
From Louisiana, I headed up to Arkansas, where I had the honor and the pleasure of fishing with the legendary Dave Whitlock. Dave took me to his beloved Crooked Creek and taught me a few things about catching smallmouth bass.
Good looking water. There he is.
You hooked up?
Nice one. Yeah, boy.
Way to go, Mr. Whitlock.
Oh, he's got his head up there. Yeah, that is a good fish.
Good job.
Yeah, what can I say, you know?
Hard to be humble, isn't it?
You know, it's just one of those things.
Yeah. Just another day on Crooked Creek.
Oh, it feels good, though, to have something bent in your rod other than a rock or a spinning line.
Wow, that's a good fish.
Yeah.
Excellent.
Come on, guys. Let's get him over here in shallow water where we can kind of see him a little bit better.
Well done.
Yeah.
Well done.
Look at the creature. Got that attitude, see?
It's a chunk of fish there. That is a chunk of fish. Gorgeous.
He's pretty thing.
You kiss more fish.
Well, they're my favorite creature other than maybe ladies, you know.
Let me see this
pretty
guy.
Thing. And nice.
Big chunk of fish.
Yeah, that's a good sight. That's more typical of the fish in this river that we kind of fish for.
Yeah.
You know, 14, 15 inch fish.
Same stripping action worked?
Yeah, you know, I just when I cast it over underneath sort of above the root, I just let it sink down a little bit deeper.
Yeah.
You know, just to kind of swing it under the reach. Your wrist hanging that, but that's where he was.
Yeah,
well. And then just a couple of strips and...
Sometimes you gotta go where you don't think you should go to find fish.
Well, that's where they are sometimes, you know, particularly one that size there.
How much you think that fish weighs?
Oh, maybe 7-10 pounds. No, probably a pound and a half, pound three quarters, you know.
Really?
It's a nice solid fish.
Yeah, kidding.
But you know, the thing is, if they're proportional to the kind of water and the tackle you catch them out of, you know, I've caught 7-pound bass that I wasn't proud of. It was just Crooked Creek smallmouth like that.
Yeah. That was a great fish. Jeez.
Well, it's time for you to go over there and get there. There's one more over there.
You're going to let me go back and catch one?
Ford Division's Fly Fishing America with Chad Foster. Brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? By Hodgman, quality outdoor products since 1838. By Cortland, fish with Cortland quality and fish with Cortland confidence. For more than 80 years, bringing you the finest fly lines in the world. And by Powell Fly Rods. Fish the same rods as we do on Fly Fishing America. Fish a Powell, the first family of fly rods.
My next stop was Utah, which just might be my favorite place to fish. That's probably because my friend and guide, Dave Larson, always finds fish, no matter what. Dave took us to the Duchesne River, where Dix Baines and I caught trout on grasshoppers all day long.
There he is. Ha ha! Just exploding after these hoppers, man. You think
nice
he hadn't eaten in 6 months.
Holding deep.
Yeah. You guys should not have given me this hole. You're way too nice. He's right here.
Yeah, that was a...
He's kind of fighting his way upstream, you know. When you don't want him to go upstream, you can't stop him.
Nope.
Dave, this fish is running upstream, taking line. I want him to run downstream so I can land him. Here he comes. There you go. On cue. Whoa. There you go.
Nice fish.
Hot dog.
Very nice.
Hot dog.
What'd you get him on? Let me guess.
Hopper.
There you go, man. Good job.
Pretty fish.
It's not where I thought he was going to be. He's kind of in the middle there. Look at that. That's every bit of long there. He liked it. Let me get some pictures of this. Oh. Pretty. There you go. You see that son of a gun. Ooh. Love that. Feisty too, man. This is a great place.
Yeah.
Are you loving this?
Especially with the current. Oh, this is great.
You want one more look?
One more look, and then, you know, I think I'm going to head up and find a place to paint.
Are you?
Find a shady area and set up.
All right. Well, we'll keep fishing.
All right. You bet.
There he is.
As an artist, Dix recognizes the connection between painting and fly fishing. And while I see the need to catch and release, Dix, with a painting, finds a way to catch and keep. I didn't have to go far to get to my next destination, Big Sky Country in western Montana. I learned a little history on the Blackfeet Indian Reservation and then wandered over to Duck Lake to sight fish for monster rainbows in the crystal clear water.
Yes, there he is. Zing! Zing! Whoa, he's coming back at me now. These fish have run me around this lake 3 times. Oh, here we go again, another 100-yard dash. Joe, where are you, man? Oh, there you are. Thank goodness. You know how normally you cast to a pot of 2 or 3 and it's the little one that grabs it?
This time.
Finally, the big one took it.
Outstanding.
The bigger of the two. Yeah, he's getting tuckered out finally. He's hit me on another 100-yard dash. I'm getting my exercise today, that's for sure. All right, are you ready?
Yep.
Oh, 1, 2, there you go.
Okay, in the net, we got it. Outstanding fish.
Look at the color on this guy. Boy, he really gets beat up, doesn't he?
Yeah, they do. Yep. These males will come in early like this and start cutting out some territory, making nests. And I guess that guy wanted to go back to the water.
He's ready to go. He deserves to go after that fight.
Yeah.
Hey, thanks for your help.
You bet.
I really never planned to leave the States, but then I got an invitation I couldn't pass up. Talk about luck. I got a chance to fish the flats of Exuma with the world champion bone fishing angler and the world champion bone fishing guide. Buck Buckenroth and Kendall Dames showed me how it's supposed to be done.
What you want to do now is if, when you lay the fly in front of a fish, you want to lead him by about foot, foot and a half, and you want to strip. You want a smooth, slow strip so that fly drags just on the bottom, hopping from mound to mound, making a little, kicking a little puff of sand, and he'll be right on top of it. And when you set, you just want a smooth set and slowly up with the tip.
So not short, quick strips?
No, no, you slow want it slow and smooth.
It really works well when you just let it sink right to the bottom and then just drag it. It'll bounce off each one of these sand mounts. It's about 6 inches apart and just puff, puff, and they'll just see that bonefish just pounce out, yeah. Just trying to grab that fly.
That's as real. That's as real as it gets.
That's right.
Yeah. All right. I am ready. You are the best! You are the best, man! This is like, how can you miss with this? Oh, God! Perfect, perfect advice. I mean, I would have waited longer to start stripping.
Stripping now, I'll let him get right on top of it.
God, jeez, this is amazing. What a deal, huh? Yeah. I am just blown away by this. Hey, Buck.
Chad, you are in, man. Huh? That is so hot.
Do I have the guide of the year here? Doggone Kendall, he can see their eyeballs.
Huh? That's about all there is to see out in this beautiful sand flat, too.
He can see their eyeballs, man. I would have waited at least 5 more seconds to start stripping. He said, go, man, go.
They're on it.
All right, whatever. I'm not gonna argue with him.
That's right.
Boy, they were beautiful coming across that flat. All right. Ooh. Got him? Beautiful. Oh, you had him.
Hey, no, you got him. He just landed.
Oh, yes. I'll get that for you.
Yeah. Oh, come on, boy.
Well hooked.
Yeah, they like that fly.
I lost my hair on that one.
Golly. He wasn't going anywhere, was he?
No, not. Well hooked.
Does it ever end? You do this all day long here? What's up?
Let's go do that all day long. Yeah.
Thanks, Kendall.
Yeah, no problem
at
all.
Good job.
Okay.
It was back to the mainland to continue my journey. A quick trip to Vermont for some beautiful scenery and some feisty trout.
Boy, you guys just...
There he is!
Vermont has a never-ending cast of characters that take their passion a little farther than you might expect.
How did I fly? Dance, trout, dance. How did I fly? How did I fly?
And if you look at the fish closely, they have smiles on their face.
What are you doing?
Hi. A little sketching?
You're drawing?
Yes.
Wool E. Booger. Is that you?
That is.
That's your name?
Well, yeah, it's my pen name.
Come on.
Yeah.
But what is this for? What are you drawing for?
I do cartoons for the Vermont Outdoor Magazine.
Really?
Yes.
That's cool.
Yeah.
So you draw and you fish, that's your life? I want to grow up and be you.
Huh? Well, I try to do that.
What a life.
It's not bad.
How did you get that name, Wooly Booger?
Well, I tie flies. I teach people how to tie. And I usually start with a Wooly Booger because it's a big fly and easy to learn. And I kind of got that nickname.
Picked up the label, huh?
Yes.
What on earth are you doing, Frank? Shh, listen, oh no, my breathable waders, stop breathing. That is cool.
That's quite a talent. You've been doing it your whole life?
Probably since I was about 12.
You're local, right? So what's the magic fly?
The Wooly Booger.
Ford Division's Fly Fishing America with Chad Foster. Brought to you by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately?
Unfortunately, all great journeys must come to an end. So I headed home to Georgia for one of the most memorable days I've ever had on the water. Brigadoon Lodge in North Georgia has it all. Great lodging, terrific food, and huge trout. I mean huge trout. Rebecca Stewart has built a retreat in the Blue Ridge Mountains that rivals any. And her partner, Jackson, manages the river with great conviction.
There he is.
Ho!
Oh, my God. Oh, my God.
Stonefly, second cast.
You're kidding.
Brown stonefly.
Look at that fish. Oh, my God. That thing's so fat it can't even jump.
Look at this. You are the best. I have absolutely no control of this fish yet. Just does whatever he wants to do. Oh no, don't go there. Don't go there.
Should I swim after
him? I think he's wrapped. I'm gonna try to bring him right into you.
He just got unwrapped. He's still wrapped.
Yep.
You want me to get wet for this fish? I'm
ready?
Taking it.
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Get him!
No, they wasn't ready. You act like I have control. Oh my gosh. Oh my God. Look at that fish.
Here you go.
Here, I think I'll hold your rod.
Switch.
Losing that fish for you.
This net is borderline big enough.
Gosh.
I gotta unwrap him first.
Wow.
Fly is right in the corner of his mouth. There it is. That's it.
Oh my God.
Look at this.
Dude, look at that fish. Okay.
Oh my God.
Look at that.
Huh? Huh? Oh, baby.
That's unbelievable.
That's something, huh? Let me tell you about that 52 degree water. I'm glad they like it.
For the past 3 seasons, I've made my way across America on an amazing journey. I caught tons of fish and made lots of friends. Some of those days really stick in my mind. I'll never forget the day the shark ate my tarpon. And the 100 fish day we had on the Roanoke River. And I'll never forget the day I spent with my dad. But now it's time for me to stay home and let someone else share the thrill and excitement of traveling cross-country fly fishing America.
When I ain't fishing, I'm working, but I ain't working overtime. I got fishy thoughts, fishy friends. I got fishing on my mind. Staring across the border in a town called Insane. Living in a shallow pool, honey, I got fishing on my brain. I got a brother named Pike and one named Bass. Now I'll be damned if they ain't a horse's ass. Yeah, they spending too much time in that corporate line. I'll tell you, I got fishing on my mind.
Yeah!
Now if I catch that money fish, I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. Gonna buy me a great long boat, fish it to Peru. Then I'll fish the Andes from Chile to Argentina. Then I'll head north to the Coca Cabana for another fishing scene. I ain't into line dancing on Saturday night. I'll tell you right now, I got fishing on my mind.